أهلا ومرحبا بكم. منصة البث المباشر توجيه اللغة الإنجليزية محافظة الإسكندرية. Dear students, dear middle two students, welcome to the English program. I'm really excited to meet you today. Today we'll be having lesson unit 3, lessons 4, 5 and 6. Okay, so are you ready to start? So let's start right now. Unit 3, great jobs. Great jobs. We will be studying lessons 3, 4, 5, and 6. The learning aims or learning objects of today's lesson are to read an article about ancient Egyptian doctors and to see how interesting the information they found thousands of years ago. Number two, you will read the text about heroes, and you will have an opportunity to talk about your own hero. Number three, you will listen to a talk about family history, and we will know what is the meaning of the word family history. You will discuss what you are proud of. And of course, we revise used too. We will learn about some work values. Okay, it's time for speaking now. Let's work together. And let's discuss about family history. Do you know much about your family history? If so, what things or what information do you know about your family members? Would you like to learn more about your family history? And if so, why is this? Okay, what can you see at this picture? Yes, there are photos. Right? They are old photos. These might be photos of your grandparents, right? Okay. So, what do you mean by family history? Family history is collecting information about your parents, sisters, brothers, children, grandparents, and uncles, any family member. And by doing or tracing family roots back, it can help a person to connect more deeply, okay, with sense of self by learning about your family past, where they came from, who they were, what they did, the dreams they had, and their achievements. Imagine how interesting to know an information about your great-grandparent. It's very interesting. Okay, now it's time for listening. And while listening to Yasser talking about his family history, I want you to answer these questions. Before listening, I want you to read question number 1 and 2. Which person in Yasser's family he's talking about? What job did the person do? So are you ready now to listen to Yasser talking about his family history? Okay, let's start.
Listen to Yasser talking about his family history and answer the questions.
I didn't used to know very much about my family history. Then, last week, I did a school project about someone in my family. So I did some research and I found out some really interesting things about my great-grandfather. I knew he used to be a doctor, but I didn't know he worked for a charity. My great-grandfather used to live in the countryside, and he worked as a volunteer doctor for the Red Crescent when there was a natural disaster or a health emergency. For example, when there was an earthquake, my great-grandfather went to help. The work was difficult and sometimes scary. He also used to look after people who didn't have much money. I feel very proud of him.
Okay, back again after listening to Yasser talking about someone in his family. So, who was Yasser talking about? Yes, I can hear you. Yasser was talking about his great-grandfather. Excellent job. Okay, what about number two? What job did the person do? Yes, he worked as a volunteer doctor for the Red Crescent, right? Wow, you did a great job here. So now you will be listening again to the same audio, but this time you will be answering questions of exercise four. And before listening, I want you to read the questions from 1 to 5. Hold your pencils and while listening, write down your answers. Let's start.
Four. Listen again. Complete the sentences.
I didn't used to know very much about my family history. Then, last week, I did a school project about someone in my family. So I did some research, and I found out some really interesting things about my great-grandfather. I knew he used to be a doctor, but I didn't know he worked for a charity. My great-grandfather used to live in the countryside, and he worked as a volunteer doctor for the Red Crescent when there was a natural disaster or a health emergency. For example, when there was an earthquake, my great-grandfather went to help. The work was difficult and sometimes scary. He also used to look after people who didn't have much money. I feel very proud of him.
Okay, so Yasser feels very proud of his great-grandfather, don't you agree? Okay, so let's check together your answers. Have you written them on a piece of paper? Yes, well done. Let's check your answers. So, Yasser's great-grandfather lived in the countryside. Excellent. He was a for the Red Crescent. He was a volunteer doctor for the Red Crescent. Number four, he helped when there was a disaster or a health emergency. Excellent. Yasser is very proud of his great-grandfather. Yasser is very proud. Yes, well done. Now, I want you to think of a family member that you are proud of. This member could be your father, your mother, your grandfather, your elder brother, whoever he is. Think, why are you proud of him? Try to write down some notes. Excellent. Let's move. Why do you think Yasser is proud of his great-grandfather? Why do you think Yasser is proud of his great-grandfather? Well, Yasser thinks that his great-grandfather did great work. He worked as a volunteer doctor for the Red Crescent. When there was an earthquake, his grandfather went to help. Moreover, he used to look after people who didn't have much money. Now, I want you to think of your own hero, okay, of your own family member that I told you to write down some notes about him while reading Yasser's poems for the admiration of his great-grandfather. Okay, great. What about studying vocabulary in the listening? Okay, the first word is project. Project. Project is a group of tasks, group of missions that need to be completed, that your teacher asked you to do, to achieve a goal. For example, I did a school project about someone in my family. I did a school project about my great-grandfather. Project. The second word is the countryside. The countryside. It's a noun. The countryside is an area outside the city where there are farms, nature, animals, trees, fresh air. Okay, can you put this word in an example? Yes, I can hear you. My great-grandfather used to live in the countryside. The countryside. Well done. Red Crescent. Red Crescent. It's an organization that helps people who are suffering from war, floods, or disease. Can you give me an example? My great-grandfather worked as a volunteer doctor for the Red Crescent. Red Crescent. Natural disaster. Natural disaster. What do we mean by the word natural disaster? It's a terrible event, such as an earthquake or a flood. For example, when there was an earthquake, my grandfather went to help. Natural disaster. Scary. Scary. It's an adjective. It means frightening. The earthquake was scary and the work was difficult. Scary. Proud of. Proud of. It's a feeling pleased with someone because they think they have done something very good. I'm proud of my great-grandfather. He is a volunteer doctor. Proud of. Okay. Now, after enjoying the listening board, what about revising used to? Remember last session, we explained used to. So we put the subject and then used to, and then followed by the verb in the infinitive form. We have here two pictures. What can you see in the two pictures here? This picture seems old, right? Because we have only the father and mother. And they had the used to have a small car. They used to have a small car. They didn't use to have a big car. This is the negative form. But now, in this picture, this is at the present time, they have a daughter and a son. and they have a big car now. So I say, they didn't used to have a big car in the past, but now they do. Now I want you to complete these questions for your partner about he or she when he was 10. When you were 10, you ask your partner, did you used to live in a different house? So what is the answer? He might say, when I was 10, I used to live in the countryside. When I was 10, I used to live in a small apartment. What about this question here? Can you answer it? Yes. Did you used to have any different hobbies? Okay. What about the third one? Did you used to walk to school? And the last one, did you used to have the same friends? Excellent. Okay, now it's time for reading. We will be reading about ancient Egyptian doctors. It's an interesting article that you will really like it. So before reading this article about ancient Egyptian doctors, I want you to match the organ with its function. Now we have three organs, brain, heart, lungs. So the first one is done for you. The brain tells the parts of our body what to do. So the brain is the maestro of the body, right? So I want you to think about the function of the heart and the function of the lungs. Yes, great job. So the heart pumps blood around the body. What about the lungs? They take in air and help us to breathe. So we have here three organs, brain, heart, lungs. And these three organs are the most important organs that the ancient Egyptian doctors discovered or found out information about them. Let's jump to the article. Okay, while reading this article, I want you to decide whether these sentences are true or false. 1 minute to read the questions. Okay, let's start. Are you ready? Yes. Okay. Ancient Egyptian doctors. We know how ancient Egyptian doctors helped their patients because they wrote down their ideas thousands of years ago. The body. Ancient Egyptian doctors understood that the heart pumps blood around the body. However, they used to think that the heart also pumps air to our lungs. They were also the first people to understand some of the things the brain does, but they did not know how important it was. Doctors used to use plants to help people with burns and stop infections. We still use some of these plants today. They also knew how to mend broken bones and sew cuts, but they didn't used to know everything. For example, they used to make medicine from animal eyes. They used to think that an animal's eye helped people who could not see. So it's an interesting article about ancient Egyptian doctors. And this article is divided into three parts. Here is the introduction. And in the introduction part, okay, he says how, okay, the ancient Egyptian doctor helped their patients. How did we know? How did we discover this? Okay. And in the second part, here it covers parts of the body. The ancient Egyptian doctor discovered the function. And in the last part, okay, it covers the ways the ancient Egyptian doctor helped their patients with. It's like the medicine or the cure. So remember what I asked you to do before reading the article? Yes, I asked you to put true or false. So let's read the sentence together and decide whether they are true or false. Number one, ancient Egyptian doctors used to write about the work. Of course, it's true. The doctors understood everything about how the heart works. Yeah, it's false. They didn't understand everything, okay? They just understood that the heart pumps blood around the body, okay? And they used to think that the heart pumps air to our lungs, and this is not true. It's not the heart. So they really didn't understand everything about the heart. So what about number three? They thought the brain was very important. What do you think? Is it true or false? Yeah, it's false. Okay. They didn't think, or they didn't know, it's written here, that they didn't know how important the brain was. So it's false. Number four. Some of the medicines we use today are the same as they were used in ancient Egypt. What do you think of this statement? Yes, it's true. Number five, we learned how to help people to see from the ancient Egyptians. False, of course false. Because it's written here that ancient Egyptian used animals' eyes to cure the blind people. And of course, this is not true. Now, I want you to practice with your partner. How do we know about ancient Egyptian doctors at the present time? How do we know about them? Yes. We know about the ancient Egyptian doctors because they wrote down their ideas thousands of years ago, maybe on the walls of the temples, the pyramids, and so on. What about number two here? What did they use to know about the heart? What did they use to know about the heart? Okay. They used to think that the heart pumped air to our lungs. Number three, what did they use to do or use to help patients? Ancient Egyptian doctors used plants to help people with burns and stop infections. And we still use some of these plants today. Excellent. Great job, my dear students. Now, I want you to think about this sentence and try to explain it from the reading. Ancient Egyptian doctors were very clever. Do you agree? Yes, we all agree. Explain. Okay. I think that they understood that the heart pumps blood. They were also the first people to understand some of the things the brain does. Not only this, in addition, The youth plans to help people with burns. They were really brilliant. Okay, vocabulary in the reading text. Burn, burn. Burn could be a verb and it could be a noun. Burn. If it's a noun, it means a damage results from either heat or sun. So we can say sunburns. If it's a verb, it means to destroy or damage by heat or fire. Yes, can you give me an example? Ancient Egyptian doctors used to use plants to help people with burns. Burn. Infection. Infection. It's a noun. When bacteria or viruses cause disease, it's infection. Infection. Mend. Mend. It's a verb. Can you guess the meaning? Yes, it means to repair or fix. I fix my car because it broke down. Cuts. Cuts. It's a noun. It means an injury when something hurts you, made by something sharp, like a knife or scissors. Cuts. Okay, now it's time for listening. Okay, so now we will be listening to two people having a class discussion. So these two girls are students at school and they are having a discussion. Now I want you to take the idea they are discussing together. Is it heroes help people? Or heroes are never scared, or heroes should work hard. Let's listen and decide what idea they are discussing. And while you're listening, I want you to complete these missing parts using the words in the box. The first word is mean, sure, understand, what, and words. Let's listen together.
This book, Unit 3, Lesson 5, Exercise 1. Listen to two people having a class discussion. Tick the correct topic.
What is a hero, Huda?
I think a hero is someone who is very brave.
What do you mean?
I mean, a hero isn't scared of anything.
I think a hero is someone who is scared, but still tries his or her best.
I'm not sure what you mean.
In other words, they often do difficult or dangerous things.
It's also about putting other people first.
Sorry, I don't understand.
I mean, a hero helps other people.
Yes, I agree.
Students' book, Unit 3, Lesson 5.
Okay, back again. It was really interesting. So, what do you think the two girls, Mona and Hoda, are talking about? So, heroes help people, heroes are never scared, heroes should work hard. What do you think is the most, all of them, by the way, can be true, but which one is the most correct one? Yes, I do agree with you. It's the first one. Heroes help people, Yes, this is the most correct idea here, right? And it's mentioned here at the last part of their conversation. I mean, a hero helps other people. That's what he does, right? Okay, so I expected that you wrote down the answers for the missing words in the dialogue between Mona and Hoda. So let's check answers now. Okay, so I mean, number two, I mean a hero isn't scared of anything. What about number three? I'm not sure what you mean. Number four, in other words. Number five, sorry, I don't understand. So we have here four important expressions. The first one, I mean, when you want to explain, okay, a word or an idea in other words, you use the expression I mean. If you are not sure of something or you doubt it, you say, I'm not sure. Again, when you want to say the ideas in a different way, you use the expression in other words. Okay, if it's difficult, you say, I don't understand. Sorry, I don't understand. Excellent, great job. Okay, this is the last part of today's session, and it's the most enjoyable part. It's the reading part. Okay. Before reading, I want you to think, who is the writer's hero and why? Yes, from the title and from the photo here, you might be guessing the right answer, right? About who is the writer's hero, because I can see the word mother here, right? So, yes, the writer's hero is his mother. So, are you ready to read? But I want you, while reading, to answer all these questions. What is the paragraph number? Which sentence in each paragraph tells us the main idea? Do the other sentences in the paragraphs give information about the main idea or something different? Okay, let's start reading together. Today, my mother is an important nurse, Mrs. Karima Muhammad. But I know that her life used to be difficult. She studied to be a nurse at the Faculty of Nursing in Ain Shams University and used to work as a nurse too, sometimes at night to learn all she could. She then got a job at a big hospital in Cairo. She continued to work hard but didn't stop her studies, and soon she became one of the most important nurses in Cairo. Now, she works in a big hospital in Cairo. In 2020, many people became ill, and she worked every day for many weeks. It was difficult, but heroic work, because most of them got better. She's also a nursing manager. And she helps to teach younger nurses. I think she is a hero because she studied and worked very hard to get an important job. And now she helps people every day. She always tells me that education is very important and that if I work hard, I can do anything. Okay, that's a very, he seems very proud of his mother, right? Don't you agree? And I'm very proud of my mom too. Okay, so if you notice the article here, it's divided into three parts, right? One, two, and three. So the essay have three paragraphs, right? So I want you to decide why the writer thinks she's the hero. Is it mentioned in paragraph number one or paragraph number two or the last one? Can you give me a number? Yes, great job. So it's written or mentioned here in paragraph number three. What about letter B? What the hero does now? So this is mentioned in paragraph number, yes, excellent, two. The last one, what the hero was like when she was younger. So this is mentioned in paragraph number one. Excellent. So which sentence in each paragraph tells us the main idea? What about paragraph number one? Where is the sentence that tells us the main idea? And by the main idea, we mean the most important information of the paragraph. That all the details in the following sentences explain it. Yes? So the main idea in the first paragraph is my mother is an important nurse. Excellent. What about the second paragraph? What is the main idea here? Yes, my mom works in a big hospital in Cairo. And then the next sentences, okay, explain the nature of his mom's work. For example, many people became ill and she worked every day for many weeks. Her work is difficult, but her weak work, and so on. Okay, what about the last paragraph? What is the most important information here? Yes, I think she is a hero. And then he gives details and information for his belief. Okay, now we have something funny here. We have easy to confuse words. For example, we might confuse the preposition to with the quantifier to. Okay, to, both of them are pronounced in the same way, but they are written in a different way. No and no. There. It, then, and then. Okay. Karima Muhammad is a great character. Can you explain? Karima Muhammad is a great character. Can you explain? Yes, from the reading passage, he explained that his mother is a very important character or a very important nurse. Okay, because she does great work at the hospital, she helps ill people, she goes to work every day for many months, and her work is heroic. Okay, and she helped people to get better. And of course, she is a nursing manager that helps other nurses, young nurses. Okay. So her work is heroic and she is an important doctor. Okay. words in the reading text. Heroic. Heroic. Heroic is an adjective. It means very brave or great. Heroic. Nursing manager. Nursing manager. A nursing manager, his or her job is to organize nurses in hospital. Do you remember the nurse manager Karima? Yes. What was her job? Part of her job was to help younger nurses, right? Okay. That's great. Okay, my dear students, now it's the end. We came to the end of our today's lesson. I hope you enjoyed it as I enjoyed it. كان معكم نورة محمود حسن. إن شاء الله ألقاكم الأسبوع القادم. Unit 4, I will be waiting for you, إن شاء الله. Thank you so much.